Well, greetings, St. Andrews, coming to you from our Great Hall today, the site of our upcoming corporate prayer event on Sunday, this coming Sunday, January 24th from 5 to 6. You'll see also, just like on Wednesday nights, our chairs and tables are spaced out more than previous years because of social distancing, so we're taking caution in that regard. But corporate prayer is an important aspect of the life of the church. We see this down through the centuries, even back to the time of the apostles in the book of Acts. The church, on a regular basis, got together for corporate prayer. And when they did, great things happened. God worked. God used those prayers to accomplish his purposes. So that's what we're going to do this coming Sunday, something that we haven't been able to do very often over the past year. And one of the things that our prayer team here at St. Andrews has tried to put before us is the importance of using God's Word to guide us in our prayers, to guide us to know what to pray for according to His will. So that's what we're going to do this coming Sunday. And as you receive this video, you'll also receive a link to a prayer guide that we're going to use for that time, to structure that time. And you'll also have access to hard copies of those guides here on Sunday. And in that guide, we were going to use 1 Peter chapter 2 as our guide to know what to pray for our church and for our community. And we've broken that passage down into five sections. We're going to praise God for calling us out of darkness and giving us a special role and mission. We're going to pray for our purity and our witness to the community. We're also going to pray for our relationship to those in power over us, our relationship to the governing authorities, a topic that is fresh on our minds due to the being an election year. And then we'll also pray that we would follow Christ's example, one who endured suffering, entrusting him and himself to one who judges justly, and to follow in his steps. And then we'll close with a time of praise. So I want to encourage you to join us for this special prayer time in person. And if not, you have a prayer guide to join us from your homes, to pray during that time from 5 to 6 on Sunday, that we might seek the face of the Lord together. What great things might He do through our prayers?